If I give you this set of 2D points, only a few seconds would be enough for you to find the closest pair of points, the one that has the minimum distance between its points. It's actually here, the pair of points in red. That was an easy one, but what if you had millions of points? It would be way harder, and that's why we need an algorithm to do the job. The closest pair of points problem is a computational geometry problem. It says that given a set of points, we want to find the closest pair as you did now. The first solution that can directly come in your mind is the brute force solution. Test every possible pair of points while keeping track of the closest one. Know that the distance between two points in a plane is calculated using the Euclidean distance formula, square root of y2 minus y1 squared plus x2 minus x1 squared. But this solution is slow. In fact, it has an off n square time complexity where n is the number of points, because of the nested for loops. What if I tell you that we can solve this problem with divide and conquer? Want to know how? Then follow this video. The idea behind this algorithm is to divide the set of points into two parts, the points that come before the midpoint and the points that come after the midpoint. After doing so, we recursively call the function to get the closest pair in the left part, delta L, and we call again to get the closest pair in the right part, delta R. You may think that now we just need to take the one that has the smallest distance among them and we're done, but no, that would have been really easy. Okay, we found the closest pair in the left part, the one in the right part, but what if in reality the closest pair is made of one point from the left part and one point from the right part? Our actual solution wouldn't detect it, because you need to understand that it's searching in the points of the left part only, then in the ones of the right part only, but it's not making the connection between them, that's the problem. How to operate then? Well, that's where the tricky part starts. We have delta L the minimum distance in the left part and delta R the minimum distance in the right part. And let's call delta the minimum distance between them. So delta is equal to min between delta L and delta R. Now we found the value of delta, and we want to see if there exists a closer pair made of a point from the left part and a point from the right part. Yes, we can traverse all the points, but why would we lose time on pairs with whom it's mathematically impossible to have a smaller distance? To limit the search space, we will traverse points whose the distance between them and the midpoint's y-axis is at most delta. So we will have a kind of a band of width 2 delta centered in the midpoint's y-axis. It contains all the points that interest us, those that are not far from the midpoint's y-axis by more than delta. Why? Let me explain. It's because if we want to find a distance smaller than delta with points that are in different parts, both points have to be in this band. If at least one of them is outside, the distance will always be greater than delta, and we're not interested by that. You have to understand that not all pairs that are inside the band are smaller than delta, but all pairs whose points are in different parts and one of them is outside the band are greater than delta. If you understood this, we can continue. Now we know that we need to traverse the points that are in the band only, and for each one of them, we need to traverse points that are also in the band. But do we need to traverse all of them? No, here again, we can reduce the search space. What if I tell you that we only need to traverse 6 points and not all of them? Let me explain. Let's for example take this point, that is in the left part. First of all, we only need to traverse points that are below the actual point, because points above are already processed. They have been processed in previous iterations. You need to understand that points that are at a distance of at most delta from our point and below it have to be in this delta by 2 delta rectangle. The reason behind it is that if we draw a circle around P of radius delta, which contains all points with which the distance is at most delta, we can see that the bottom part of it is included in that rectangle. It means that all the points we're searching for are in this rectangle. And this rectangle can contain at most 6 points that are far from each other by at least delta. Okay, but why would they have to be far from each other by at least delta? Because if they're not, there would be a contradiction. The contradiction is that if there are two points in the same side whose the distance is smaller than delta, then delta is not even the smallest distance in that side, which is contradictory because we called the function recursively and found that the smallest distance is delta. Finding a smaller one made of two points of the same side is a contradiction, because if delta prime, which is smaller than delta, really existed, we would have found it before. Let's see some examples to show you that there can't be more than 6 points in this rectangle that respect the condition. Let's for example put a point here, another one here, and another one here. you can see that if we want to add another point in the left side of the rectangle, it has to be in one of the circles, which gives a distance smaller than delta, contradiction. Because if this point really existed, we would have found delta prime as a minimum distance and not delta. Same thing for the right side, we can't add a point unless inside a circle, which is a contradiction. Let's try again. We put a point here, and the rectangle is already filled with circles. We can't add another point, we've been able to put only two ones. Let's try again. We put a point here, 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 and here. We've put six. You can see that we cannot add another point without putting it in a circle of its side. So even if we try to put the points in the extremities of the rectangle, we've been able to put 6 points only without violating the condition. Adding a single point would make a contradiction. I know that some of you are still not convinced and wonder what would happen if there are more than 6 points in the delta by 2 delta rectangle below our point. But it's just impossible, because at least 2 of them in the same side would form a distance smaller than delta, which would have been found in the first part of the algorithm, hence reducing the rectangle size and going back to at most 6 points. Okay, recap. We searched for the midpoint. We recursively called the function to search for delta L. We recursively called the function to search for delta R. We calculated delta by taking the minimum between delta L and delta R. And then, we wanted to check if there isn't a closer pair made of one point in the left side and one point in the right side. For that, we started by reducing the search space, to avoid processing useless points. To do so, we extracted the points that are found from the midpoint's y-axis by at most delta. They belong to the band of size 2 delta that is centered in the midpoint's y-axis. After it, we also reduced the search space by traversing only points that belong to the delta by 2 delta rectangle that is below the actual band point, because remaining ones are either already processed or far from P by more than delta, we don't care about them. And the maximum number of points in that rectangle is 6, this is why we will do only 6 iterations of the inner loop. The reason behind 6 has been explained earlier, it's because a 7th point would cause a contradiction. After traversing the 6 next points of each point in the band, we can return the closest pair, the one we're searching for. If you didn't understand something in this process, especially the part with the rectangle and all that stuff, write it down right now in comments. Now it's time to have a look at the code of this solution. You have to know that to avoid sorting at each recursive call, we will sort the points at the beginning to not having to do it later. We will sort them once by their x value and once by their y value. We need both orders. We need them sorted by x to find the midpoint and easily distinguish the left part from the right one, and we also need them sorted by y when traversing the 6 next points of each point in the band, because we need the 6 points that are just below the actual point. So the input is points, an array of tuples where each tuple has 2 elements, the x value and the y values, and we create x sorted and y sorted. X sorted is the same set of points but sorted according to their x value, as you can see in the comparison key. And y sorted contains the points sorted according to their y value. And we call the recursive function. In the recursive function, we store the number of points in n, then the base case is when we have at most 3 points. Here, we can just use the brute force method, it's not a big deal. And in the recursive case, we calculate the midpoint, is the one at index n by 2 in x sorted, then we split x sorted into x sorted left and x sorted right, by taking the point before the index n by 2, which is the midpoint, and points starting from n by 2 respectively. And to fill y sorted left and y sorted right, we just traverse points in y sorted and append to the right side depending on if the x value is before or after the midpoint. Now, we get the closest pair in the left part recursively, same thing for the right part, and we put the minimum between delta L and delta R in delta. Now, remember that we first need to find points that are in the band. For that, we traverse y sorted to get points sorted by y value, and take only those whose x value is between midpoint's x value minus delta, and midpoint's x value plus delta. Last step, for each point in the band, we traverse the next 6 points, and if the distance is smaller than delta, we replace the closest pair in delta. At the end, we just return P1 and P2, the closest pair, and delta, their distance. To better understand the algorithm, here is an animation that shows what happens. For the time complexity, let's first have a look at the recursive function. We have n to split x sorted, n to split y sorted, t of n by 2 for the recursive call on the left side, and t of n by 2 for the right side. T of n by 2 because we're calling with half of the points. We also have n to find the points that are in the band, n iterations for the outer loop, and 6 iterations for the inner loop, because we're checking the next 6 points only, which gives 6 times n. The total is t of n equal to 2 times t of n by 2 plus 9n, which is 2 times t of n by 2 plus theta of n. By using the master method, whose generic form is t of n equal to a times t of n divided by b plus theta of n power c times log n power d, we found that a is 2, b is 2, c is 1, and d is 0. Log b of a is log 2 of 2, which is 1, so we have c equal to log b of a. We're in the second case. D is greater than minus 1, so t of n is equal to theta of n power c times log n power d plus 1, which is theta of n log n by replacing. This recursive function has a theta of n log n time complexity. We also have the cost of solving points by x value, theta of n log n, the cost of solving points by y value, theta of n log n. The total is 3 times theta of n log n, which is also theta of n log n. So this divide and conquer solution has a theta of n log n time complexity, which is way better than the brute force solution. We reached the end of this video. In this one, we presented a tricky but interesting algorithm to find the closest pair of points in a plane. Ask me in comments if you didn't understand something. Subscribe to the channel and see you in the next one.